smell, touch, vision, hearing, taste. Equilibrioception? Proprioception? Interoception? How many senses are there? Welcome to InfOT. Today we will explore our 8 senses. Most people know that there are 5 senses: vision, hearing, touch, smell, and taste. As therapists, we are taught that there are 2 more: proprioception and vestibular. Lately, there is much research focusing on an 8th sense, the interoception. But more research indicates that there might be way more senses than just 8. Some researchers suggest that there are actually 21 senses, or 53, including pain, temperature, sense of self, and many more. In this video, we will try to cover just 8 of them, the ones we usually take more into consideration as therapists. Let's start with the easy ones. Sight, or vision, helps us see objects in our environment. Our eyes capture the light and send the signal into our brain to interpret it. Our vision is the sense that can have the greatest impact on all other senses. When seeing a bottle of water, our brain immediately knows how much it weighs. Some interesting facts about sight. Most of us can see around 150 colors, although some people see more colors. Our feelings can affect our vision and what we see, and the colors we see can also affect our feelings. The ear, or to be more specific, what's inside our ear, is the most important organ when it comes to audition or hearing. Inside our ear resides the cochlea, which is responsible for receiving vibrations of the air and transform them into sounds. Our ears can distinguish between 3 types of sounds. You can hear me right now, right? That's the first one, human speech. We also hear everyday sounds, like cars passing by, rustling, the wind. And lastly, we hear music. Vision and hearing are working very closely with each other. You might have noticed that when you look at something, you can actually hear it better. A scent is the fastest sensation you can perceive. Olfactory, or smell, is happening right under our noses. Small air particles invade our noses and let us know if something is good or bad, tasteful or not, safe or unsafe. A familiar smell can instantly bring back memories more than any other sense. What you smell affects your feelings, but you can also smell other people's feelings, unconsciously of course. When we are talking about gustatory, or taste, the tongue is your most important organ. We can distinguish between 5 tastes: sweet, sour, bitter, salty, and umami. We are not born with the ability to taste all tastes. That's why babies prefer more sweet tastes like milk, and at around 1 year old, they start to perceive spicy foods. After a certain point in our lives, our taste receptors tend to deteriorate with age. Last one from the easy ones, tactition, or touch. Touch receptors live in the largest human organ, the skin. The sense of touch informs you that something has just touched you. You need to use your other senses to determine what is touching you. That's why touch is considered a multisensory system. Our touch is more sensitive in our fingertips, lips, and toes. We can perceive a touch as a light touch, as a deep pressure, as a hot or cold touch, and as a stretch. Moving on to equilibrioception and or the sense of balance. Occupational therapists know this as the vestibular sensory system. Located in our inner ear, the sense of balance does exactly what it says, keeping us in balance. The sense of balance lets us know where our head is located, whether we are up or down, left or right, or upside down. It works really closely with our sight sense. The vestibular system helps us move up and down the stairs without falling. The sense of balance may make us nauseous when spinning around really, really fast, or make us vomit during a road trip. The sense of balance works together with the body awareness sense, or proprioception. Together, they give us a clear indication of where our body is without using our vision sense. We know, at any given moment, where our body parts are. The proprioception sensors reside in our muscles and joints. Close your eyes and touch your nose. That's the proprioception sense in a nutshell. It helps us move between objects without crashing onto them. Lastly, our gut sense, the interoception. Interoception helps us understand what our body needs. Whether it's hunger, temperature, need to pee, or tiredness, your interoception sense is telling you that. The interoception receptors are inside our organs, and they send messages to our brain. Then, our brain needs to decode these messages. A growling belly might mean that the person is hungry. A high fever and shivering might indicate that the person is sick. The interoception sense is also linked to our emotions. For example, when you are extremely stressed, you might feel dizziness, your cheeks might be red and your hands sweaty. That's your interoception system telling you to stop. Take a break. Make sure to watch our other video for more information on the interoception sense. That's a wrap-up on the 8 senses that we mostly take into consideration in our lives as therapists. Did you know about the 3 extra senses we explored? Leave your comment below to tell us. All information in this video was found here. Thank you for watching InfOT. If you liked the video, feel free to like and subscribe. Stay tuned for more.